Today, we're combining a colorful portrait with graphics to create a unique artistic effect. We got a great tutorial for you. Let's jump into Photoshop. So we're starting off with this really cool image. Now, I found this splatter effect on Adobe Stock, and you guys can download this. We'll link to it right down below. Now, with this sort of thing, you might be tempted to just change your blending mode from like normal down to multiply and then kind of like see how it interacts. And like, it's cool, but like, obviously like the colors, I don't want this green. I want it to all be that magenta color. And I want like actual like opacity. I don't want it to just all blend in with the image. I want it to look like some of the background is actually like coming over and like, you know, covering up some of my subject. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna just change this back to a normal blend mode. And then I need a way to select these colors, but I don't wanna just select it so it's like fully selected and fully not selected. I want like transparency and I want some mix involved in there. And to do that, we're gonna be using channels. Now channels, I know they sound fancy and complicated. They're just ways to make selections. So just go to window and then down here to where it says channels. There we go. So basically how channels work, they're a fancy way of making selections. The light areas get more selected and the dark areas get less selected. So we just want to take a look at the channels that like have more information. So red information, you can see some of this stuff is missing. Green, we got a lot. Blue, a little bit less. So we're just going to use the green channel because it has the most information. So let's go ahead and turn this into a selection. You can hold control or command and click right here on the thumbnail. Boop, and you can see it's now selected. Or you can click right here on this selection icon, and that's going to turn this into a selection. So now that we have this as a selection, we can go back to our layers panel. We're going to make a new layer. Now, keep in mind, channels will select the lighter areas of your image. So for instance, if I wanted to, let's create, just make that invisible. If I just use my brush tool now, and I just paint with my green brush or something like that, you can see it's basically selected where the lighter areas were selected. Now, because the splatters were the darker areas, I need to inverse that selection. Super easy to do. Just go up here to select and then down to inverse. Boom. So now it's the darker areas of my image that are selected. And what we want to do is fill that with this magenta color from the background. Okay, so I'm on a new layer here. We're just going to go to edit and then down here to fill. There we go. Now where it says contents, we're just going to choose color. All right, let's choose color. And then you got your color picker up. And then if you just bring your like cursor over here, there we go. You can see it just has an eyedropper and you can actually just pick your background color. So let's hit okay. All right, we've got our color. It's gonna fill. Let's hit okay. And then boom, controller command D to deselect. So let's go ahead and make our background invisible. This is basically what we have now. So channels, if anytime you have like a logo or something like that on a background and you wanna isolate it and put it on a transparent background, like channels are a really good way to do that. They're great at making selections. You can fill them with any color and then you can isolate, put it on a transparent background. So that's kind of what we have here, right? These cool splatters, you can see they have transparency built into them, right? So it's a lot of detail, a lot of transparency, really, really nice effect. So when I place this over top of my subject, it's gonna have more depth than it would if I just use like a multiply blend mode or other like simple blend modes and things like that. All right, so let's go ahead and make our subject back visible. And now we have these really cool splatter effects that we can kind of like take over top of our subject and decide where we do and don't want these to be visible. Now, I'm gonna duplicate this because we're actually gonna do this a couple of different times. And I like a lot of these effects. Like I think a lot of it looks pretty cool, but in some areas I don't like this area here. We're gonna use a lasso tool to make that a selection. I don't want that covering up my subject's nose. That doesn't look really cool, right? So I'm gonna just make that a selection, okay? And then on our layer mask, I'm just gonna click on the layer mask. Boom. Now you're gonna see this happens a lot with layer masks. Like if you make a selection and click on your layer mask, it does the opposite of what you want. Not a big deal. Just click right here on your layer mask. Just be sure this white bounding box is actually around the layer mask. See, layer is selected, layer mask is selected. So look, make sure your layer mask is selected and hit Control or Command I, and then now it's actually what I want. Cool. Let's go ahead and we're gonna select some of this area here. I don't want that on her forehead either. I don't think that's very interesting, but all the rest of it, I think it actually looks pretty cool. So let's select that. And then on the layer mask here, I can just fill this with black. So let's go to edit. We're gonna go down to fill just like earlier. And then here, we're just going to choose black. There we go. Let's fill that with black. Now this already looks like pretty cool. It's like a unique effect. We can just turn this off and on. We can see like, yeah, it looks kind of like the background is splattering over top of our subject. But I want to take this one step further. I wanted to actually interact with like my subject's face and eyes and things like that in a more interesting way. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna take this layer and duplicate it. And now let's bring it like over top of our subject's face. Okay, we'll go ahead and zoom in a little bit. We're gonna use blend if to make sure this is only visible either in the shadows or in the highlights. We're gonna test them both out, see how we feel. So let's go ahead and double click right here on the layer. So if you have your layer, just go right over here to this gray area and double click right there, which brings up your layer style. I'm just gonna bring this all the way to the right so we can see what we're doing. Now, here at the very bottom, let's bring this up a little bit there. So here at the very bottom, you can see it says blend if, and you have your current layer and your underlying layer, okay? Now we have two sliders here. We're gonna bring that a little bit over there so you can see. We have the sliders on the left-hand side, okay? And if I bring that from the left to the right, you're going to see over here, check that out, you're gonna see it's gonna start to disappear from the dark areas, okay? On the right-hand side, it's gonna start to disappear from the light areas. Now, if you hold Alt or Option and separate these, you can see it actually becomes two separate little sliders, and that's gonna be feathering, which is gonna be much more interesting. So instead of, like, if you don't hold Alt or Option, you can see how, like, kind of grainy and just, like, it doesn't actually blend that well, but if you do hold Alt or Option and separate these sliders so you have two, there we go. Now you start to see some actually, like, really interesting effects where it's actually blending together a lot better. There we go. And that's kind of what we want with this. Like, I want that like blended together effect. And this is starting to look pretty cool. So let's hit okay here. And now I kind of move this around. So we have this like splatter effect and like here over top of the eyes, I think that's looking really cool. There we go. Again, like this is just supposed to be like a little bit more of like an interesting type of, yeah, like that's actually pretty cool. Like what it's doing with the fingernails. I'm gonna hit Control or Command J to duplicate that. And then I want just to be visible like in a couple different places, right? So we're just gonna move this around. Keep in mind, you can always double click right here in this gray area and you can kind of just change your blend if effect, right? Like I can make it more or less visible in different areas. There we go, let's hit okay there. And I can kind of move this around too. So this is kind of like part of the fun of these effects is like you can really just kind of like pick and choose how you want them. Control or Command J to duplicate that. And like, I want this to be visible in a few different areas around my image, just because it's more interesting, right? There we go, Control or Command J to duplicate that and kind of bring it around there. And then you can always use a layer mask to decide like where you do and don't want these effects to be visible. But like, I think this is already looking really, really cool. I want some more visibility like up on her like head area. There we go, let's just bring that over there and change this, there we go. Fantastic. So it's like, yeah, that looks really, really cool. So now all these layers, I'm just gonna shift click all of these layers and hit Control or Command G and turn them off or on. And then I can decide like, is there any areas that like I don't want this to be visible? And then I can just use the layer mask for that. But I actually think it like, it totally works for the majority of this image. Maybe just like right here in that eye. So I can just put a layer mask on the entire group. And then I'm gonna hit L for my lasso tool. There we go. And then I'm gonna hit shift delete and then fill that with black. Fantastic. Now I do want some sort of effect on this eye, but not that much. So I'm gonna hit Control or Command J on this entire group and just start moving the entire group around. There we go. To see like where I want this to be visible on the eye. Like what's, you know, what's subtle, but actually interesting, right? There we go. And as we move this around, like, yeah, I think that's actually looking pretty cool. So we got this entire group here. There we go. And I think this actually works for the most part, but I really just want this to be visible like on the eye in that area. Okay, so I'm gonna click on this layer mask. We're just gonna hit shift delete, fill that with black on the layer mask. And then I can just use the brush tool and kind of like paint it back visible just in the areas that we want. All right. It's kind of cool, like right there on the fingernail, stuff like that too. But you can see this effect like really blends into the image because we have this blend if, making it only visible in the shadows. And then of course we just have this full on effect that's just visible kind of everywhere. But I think this totally, totally works. Maybe not so much right there. I'm not a fan of it right there. So let's just use our brush tool. I can just paint with black right over there. And there we go, to kind of like make that disappear. But everywhere else I think like really, really works, and we just have a little bit more of an interesting portrait to begin with. So let's go ahead and just shift click. I'm gonna group all that. Let's hit F for full screen and check out, here's our before and the after. Just a little bit more interest, a little bit more way to like create a creative photo by adding some of these graphics into an existing cool image. Thanks so much for watching. I'll Phlearn you later. Bye everyone. Anything that's fully black is 0%. All right.